Good morning, Oppo Stars. Welcome to another edition of Mom and Me. Today we'll be demonstrating, or rather, she'll be demonstrating Olan. Lema, enna Olan?
Parenka.
Okay, this is Parenka Olan, and Olan you can use any vegetable. White pumpkin is common. Today we'll do this with squash or Parenka. Enna ye cholunga? Ninga chola chola thana pannano.
Thenga thappu
utko. One layer of coconut oil. Olan is a Keralite dish. So coconut oil is preferred, and a quarter cup of water.
தண்ணி கொஞ்சம் ಜಾಸ್ತಿ வெச்சுக்காத போதும்.
ಜಾಸ್ತಿ இல்ல வேண்டாம். போ எல்லாம் வேகும். ஒண்ணு எல்லாம் பருமையா வேகும். So we'll add quarter cup of water.
தட்டப்பை
போடு. I'm going to add half a cup of sprouts. You can use sprouts or just soaked lentils. It's perfectly okay. Spread it a bit, and then any vegetable you like. Usually white pumpkin or red pumpkin is preferred. So this is for the protein, this is for the starch. This is a starchy vegetable. Spread it around. Couple of slit chilies. This is a very lightly spiced dish. So the only spices we are going to add are some chilies, some turmeric, quarter teaspoon of turmeric. And some jaggery. This is completely optional. This is just to sweeten it a bit. A teaspoon of salt. That's it. We'll be mixing in coconut milk after we open. Close and cook on high for a couple of whistles. Okay. In the meantime, let's prepare some coconut milk. You have the coconut milk powders available. These are very convenient to use. You also get coconut milk in sachets. So open the pack and just add the powder and dilute it a bit. So she wants to empty half the pack. Dilute it with water. Make it as thick or as thin as you like. And your coconut milk is ready. That's it. See? So all you have to do is, after the Olan is cooked, you're just going to mix in some coconut milk and mix in some curry leaves. So the only flavoring is coming from turmeric powder, coconut oil, and a bit of chilies. And the raw curry leaves. Then and we are also going to use some coconut oil as a garnish. So that is done. I'll keep this aside and start layering for the next dish. This is what we are going to prepare next. This is called chena archakalaki. So basically this is a raita variant, where yam is cooked and mashed with coconut cumin chili paste. And tadka is added. If you are from the western belt, you would know that this has an echo of tambli, where coconut cumin chili paste mixed with yogurt is used as a base for a lot of dishes. This is not very popular in Tamil Nadu. The echo is from Kerala. Archakalaki is one dish where a starch is mashed, mixed in with yogurt and coconut cumin chili paste. Okay? So we'll start the layering for that. A layer of coconut oil. Quarter cup of water. This is about a cup of yam. I would have chopped it finer, but yam cooks very fast, so this shouldn't make a big difference. Ensure that all the peels are removed. Okay. I'm going to add the coconut cumin chili paste with the cup over this, so that it doesn't touch the bottom and burn. Idhu samikkanuma appadiye podalama amma? Idhu samikkanuma vendama?
Onnu
vendam. Onnu vendam. Ellam idhu mattum idha mattum vega vecha
podalama?
Enna thanni vachu?
Idha vechu uppu podu.
A bit of salt. She says there is no need to cook the coconut cumin chili paste. So we'll just cook this, mash this,
Leah.
Mash this, mix in the coconut cumin chili paste.
And thyme.
And some yogurt and our chena arachikalaki will be done. You can do the same thing with any starchy vegetable. I'm going to switch this off. Remove the pressure. Coconut milk, that is, it's cooked perfectly, looks very nice. The lentils seem to be cooked well too. Yeah, this is cooked well too. They're not mushy, they still have a bite, and that's where you want it. You don't want them to disintegrate. I'm going to mix in some coconut milk, some crushed curry leaves and coconut oil and a bit of coconut oil. This is virgin coconut oil, cold pressed. It has an intense flavor. Just mix up everything. This is a soup. This is chunky soup in disguise. It's a nutritionally balanced soup. If you want it into convert this into a smooth gravy, all you need to do is just mash it. Okay, I'm just going to mash one part of it to show how it looks. So this is up to you, or you can have a combination of both. Mash up half, let the other half remain as chunks so that it has a more interesting texture. It's ultra simple. Extremely delicious, gets done in minutes, 5 minutes I think. So we'll just put this on the stove while the time we are preparing this. Cook this for a couple of whistles, mix in some coconut cumin chili paste, some tadka, this is mustard seeds fried in coconut oil, along with some dry red chilies and curry leaves. So I'm going to mash this, mix in some tadka, mix in some coconut cumin chili paste, and mix in maybe half a cup of yogurt. One second, let me just get the yogurt here. So these are the only three ingredients needed for the arachikalaki. Any starchy vegetable which is cooking here, some coconut cumin chili paste which is an Opo staple, some bottle tadka, it can be real plain bottle tadka, nothing fancy, and some yogurt. Pressure bake it's starchy vegetable, mash it up, mix all this, call it a raita variant, call it a thambli, call it a arachikalaki, it's up to you. Arachikalaki vera enna podalam chenakkanangu thavara pickled mango, baby mangoes are also used for arachikalaki, so that becomes a kind of a pickled raita. So as that need not be cooked, that can be just be the pickled mango can just be blended with all this, not the tadka of course, can be just blended with this into a smooth dip. Okay, so this is mostly done. Let me test pat cholunga. This goes gorgeously well with hot rice. And so if you just use a vegetable alone, it is simple olan. If you add some protein to it, as in the form of lentils, whole lentils, then it becomes one paya olan, or just means olan with lentils. Just switch this off, release the pressure. You can let it settle because there is no chance of yam getting discolored or overcooking. It's perfectly okay. But I'm going to release the pressure. I think it will be cooked by now. My mom doesn't seem happy. வந்திருக்குமா வேகத்தை வந்திருக்காதா சொல்லுங்க பார்க்கலாம். அப்புறம் எதுக்கு ரிலீஸ் பண்ண வேண்டாம்னு சொன்னீங்க ஏமா? See, it's all nicely mashed up. It's completely cooked in 3 to 4 whistles. Just mash it up. You can also use a immersion blender to do this. For mama. நான் சொல்றது எதுவும் கேட்கறது இல்லையா? நீங்க நீங்க சொல்றது மட்டும் நான் அதை கேட்கணும்.
என்னடா நீ சொன்னதே புரியலடா பாபு.
என்னது போய் புரியல? எது சொன்னாலும் தலை தலை ஆட்டி கேளுங்க. ஆனா பண்றது நீங்க பண்ண சொல்லி நீங்க பண்றதே பண்ணுங்க. சாரி
போறதுக்கு
பச்சை மாதிரி. ஆமா சாரி. So we mix in some coconut cumin chili paste, some yogurt. Just mix it all together and look at that shaping, taking shape. See, this is it smells divine. People from the Konkan region will immediately recognize this as a thambli variant. They have 1,000 varieties of thambli. In Tamil cuisine, we just have a couple of variations of that. Now, this tadka is slightly different because it also uses cumin, mustard, dried red chilies, curry leaves and hing. Leah, mix it up. And your chena arachikalaki is ready. This goes well with rotis. You can have this with rice. Or you can pair it with
olan.
Okay. So olan and hot rice accompanied by this. Or this and hot rice paired with the olan. The combinations are extremely flexible. Try this out and post your feedback. Look at how easy it is to conjure up a mouth-watering spread. It just takes minutes. That is the beauty of mature cuisines like the Indian cuisine, which do not rely on recipes but on very flexible themes. You can mix and match stuff. You can never go wrong once you understand the key building blocks, once you understand the basics. Go live, preferably with your mom or grandma, and let us show what you are cooking up in your kitchen. Thank you very much.